All good, dude.
Monday night battle right now. Sorry, the boiler room. Shout out to them though.
Yeah, boiler room's tight.
Yeah, good place to go.
Hey man, when fucking Raw and Nitro are going at it, those are the best years ever.
Yeah. I was gonna play the Raw is War fucking. Yeah. Just like real wrestling. Oh, we lost a viewer. That's fucked up.
Yeah, what the hell?
Trying to get the fucking... You're gonna miss out from the... Oh, no!
Start it over.
I sat live at Monday Night Raw.
Oh, we lost a viewer. It's fucked up. Trying to get the fucking...
Dude, I don't like ad block, dude. I'm a fucking American.
Start it over.
They need to make money. Oh, no, I don't want to be Alex. That's bad. Medium kick, maybe. Yeah, we fucked up, dude. It's all bad. Anyways. Sorry for being a little late. I'm still getting used to it all.
But thanks for joining us.
Thanks for joining us. Let's play some Third Strike now. Let's stop fucking around. My little Yang. Sorry, man. Viewer list. Oh, you can see the viewers. That's cool.
If you want to see my fucking mug. Thanks, XO.
Let's be in kill stage. Alright. Welcome, Lance.
Thank you for tuning in.
Speak up, man.
Yeah.
You guys are being awful timid today.
Let your voice be heard.
Just let you guys know, a little fun fact, my Necro is really good. Lance knows.
What do you think is the worst Necro color? I don't like the gold.
Yeah, it reminds me of fucking family fun, like scrubs.
Yeah, exactly.
Turbo. What is that little thing? That's neat.
What the fuck does that mean?
It says turbo. Turbo like the fucking American Gladiator?
Oh, sick.
Welcome. I liked your show.
You should have let the fucking amateurs win more.
I loved it when fucking Steve Urkel was on your show. Do you remember that episode?
No.
Yeah, sick, dude.
Did you ever play the... the NES.
Yeah, it's really sick.
It's fucking hard, man.
It's really hard. Doesn't make sense.
There's some events I never beat. So many NES games are really hard.
Look at this fucking... Loved your show. My favorite event was Powerball and the Eliminator.
Powerball is when they had like all the fucking Nerf guns, right?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
That was an assault or something like that.
That was my favorite. And the Chouse was tight, man.
What's up, Cody? Yeah, the fucking Powerball was the only where it's just like smear the queer, and everyone would always get hurt.
Oh yeah,
had to
dude.
Fucking throw the ball in the little fucking laundry basket. Let's get John in the picture.
Thank you.
Shut up, bro. Joust was sick.
Smear the queer.
Oh, dude, fucking hamster ball was fucking cool.
Oh yeah, man.
I liked hamster ball,
and the like all the smoke would blow up their
yeah,
ass.
Yeah, dude, that was sick.
Hey, so you figured out how to...
Oops. What's up?
You figured out how to make videos work on this with sound.
It didn't work.
There was no sound on the raw thing?
No, that's why that's funny.
Yeah.
have to throw a lot of fucking my tokens. Chris Necro with the video.
I think so.
Yeah, dude. Go. I don't. It's really hard for Necro to do, but that's weird.
Time in the world to use that move. Jump forward strong.
Yeah, that's why I did it. Never do that move. Yeah, my fucking Necro is really good. Feeling myself right now hard. Almost could beat Arteus. Lance knows what I'm talking about.
Whatever happened to Arteus?
It's a fucking psycho. Yeah. Whoa, hit my fucking shoelace. Oh, that was it.
Big fucking heel.
Still on Xbox Live, that fucking guy? That guy was a fucking goober, dude.
Who is the 12 player that's kind of like him? He's a freak.
Red Larry?
What?
Yeah, there's some guy named Red Larry.
Kinda like that name.
Yeah, that would've worked online though, you would've shorted my ass. Brown dog, yeah! Brown dog.
Brown dog?
Red Larry too. Something
wacky. Start off a little fucking.
Yeah, we can do that. Yeah, let's do something a little wacky.
Wow, I'm gonna be a faggot right
now. What's
up, man? I'm gonna be a real faggot.
Oh no.
So you said wacky, dude.
Alright.
I don't really know her that well. So don't be like, yeah, I'll get wacky too.
Can't she play Oro? Can't she play Oro?
Oh yeah, I'll play Oro.
Alright, I'm gonna use fucking Remy, dude. What's the color of his blue pants? We're gonna get weird right now. Going to fucking club Metro.
Yeah, it's ladies' night at Club Metro.
Club Metro.
So Ryan gets in free.
Oh, I got the game on too. I didn't want this color. Fuck! John has a really problem with fucking Remy. We can talk about that later.
I can play him okay.
Talking about your fucking game.
Yeah, I know shit, dude, I know. Well, that's fucking well spaced. Nice job.
B-Tran. Yes, Pherai vs. Remy is the greatest match in Third Strike history. Better than all the sickest tournaments. Better than fucking Kuroda vs. Ino.
I sent this online, dude. I saw the female version of Kuroda the other day. Not like...
Now, what did you mean by that?
Yeah, not like it looks like, oh, there was this girl that was so sick at Third Strike. Just looks like fucking Kuroda. Like, same face.
That's weird.
Really weird. But she's stylish.
Steezy.
Yeah, really steezy. Blonde hair. Was super Saiyan hair.
Was she hot?
Kind of, man. Oh. She dressed like an idiot. I mean, it was like steezy, but like Tokyo girl idiot steez.
Yeah, wacky. Like straight wackiness.
Yeah, wearing like a double XL t-shirt. Fucking like painter's shorts or something.
So you heard it here first. Pherai thinks Kuroda is attractive.
What is going on?
Oh, I thought we were fucking, I didn't know we were arcade mode.
Yeah.
Aw, man, it's fucking... Anyways, I used to play Remy for a while, so I kind of know what to do.
I got like a fucking 5-win streak at Safari with Remy last week.
Nice.
Yeah. Even against our Yun boy. His Remy and his Yun. Which was fucking weird.
That is surprising. Yeah, dude. Kuroda's fucking cool. Love that guy.
He's a really good guy. I hate this color.
This Remy color?
Yeah.
Yeah, I didn't want this one. It is good. Got the EX at least. Remy vs. Jun is like 7-3-8-2.
Could be worse.
Let's go.
Mr. Remy with him. Fuck.
Yeah. If you don't know what, like, you have to really know how to play against Remy, otherwise you're just fucking...
You just keep getting, like, jabbed and fucking sonic boomed, and all of a sudden you're dead.
Yeah.
Everything does shit damage.
You just try to throw shit against the wall and see if it sticks, and you end up just
getting jabbed. Yeah, exactly.
Fry doesn't have a cell phone. He does, but it doesn't work in Japan. Works in fucking New Zealand, of all places.
Yeah.
Which is not really useful.
Yeah. Small country. Pick some Wi-Fi. But I'm not gonna be heartbroken if my Oro loses to Remy 5-0.
Yeah.
I'll be able to sleep at night.
Actually, yeah, Remy's not that... I mean, yeah, he sucks, but it's fun to play versus Pherai. I mean, it would suck to play against, like, some fucking really good Chun player or something.
Most characters suck against a good Chun player.
These guys are giving you some pointers, but there's no way you're going to incorporate that in the next match.
That's real kind of you, but...
No. Look who you're talking to.
Let's be realistic here, guys.
Yeah.
Tom looks like the kind of guy that can learn a thing or two. Can't teach an old dog new tricks.
Can't teach a gay dog straight tricks.
I'm gonna teach that in my English classes. This is kind of a common saying around my house.
Oh no, I'm dead. You don't fuck up.
Oh, just like I.
I'm dead.
I'm wearing the guard break.
I guess it's easy though, but you have to practice it. Thank you, Jinrai Canada.
Jinrai, Jesus Christ, that's an old name.
Yeah,
last one in the past. No kidding, yeah. Thank you for tuning in.
So I don't know how to do Kara somersault kick.
I don't know either. Strong, right?
Thought it was. That was crouching strong.
I think it's standing strong.
Okay.
Jinrai reminds me of browsing SRK in like 2008.
Back in the good old days.
Yeah, I know. People were discussing strats in the character sub forums. Fucking tight.
Well, no, I wanted to fucking. Dude, go! That was way too long. Whoa.
I fucking threw two, you faggot! Fuck it!
Just like Nika KO, you can be Jinrai Canada.
Yeah, we're all thinking of adopting those names.
Yeah. I heard, Jamaican Mester.
Dude, he's sick.
He's pretty good.
Yeah.
2-2.
I don't know.
3-2 me?
Yeah.
Okay. Go!
I'm getting dirty now. Plenty of damage against fucking pussy ass Remy. Making this.
Egyptian boss is pretty good too. Mexican Yuki. He's really good.
Fucking hell. feel like I needed to mix up there.
Japanese Pherai, he's probably cooler than regular Pherai.
Definitely better than me.
Yeah. It's pretty good. 3-3.
Oh! Then you can't do that. Ah. Are you fucking cool?
I know you're the creed of into the heat of battle. Go for it.
Yeah, I never practiced it. We should practice that someday. Dash it, flash. That's a word. Yeah, that was kind of cool.
Commentate like a first to 10 today, even if we don't have sound. So I want to know, like, what do the viewers think? Would that be whack to watch a fucking first to 10 without sound and just commentary?
Yeah. Welcome. Oh, Rowan. What's up, dude?
Yo, man. Talk to him in ages.
And then Faisley. Sorry, I can't pronounce your name, but thank you for tuning in. I'm sure you could .com. Commentate Lance versus Ryan. That'd be good.
Yeah, that sounds like a good idea. Where is it?
It's on YouTube.
Is that over in the shoulder cam?
Yeah. Yeah, what's up, man? Long time to see. So, 4-3 now. Hi, Remy's. This is a pretty good match right here. Pretty good matches going on.
It's like probably about as even as it's been out of any set we've had. See, I like that fucking color, man. That's sick. Right here.
Yeah, the fucking eel color. Braver.
Yeah!
I love how that fucking medium kick goes right underneath your hard kick. Just looks like third Street Fighter. Yeah, I can use a beer. It's 2 p.m. right now. We don't have any, so I have to go get some. I just killed myself. I don't know if that was the best punish, but I didn't know what to do.
Engage. excited about this now.
I was just, I thought I figured out the secret was just keep doing flash kick. I was like, oh, I got it now. I remember. From that fucking YouTube, man.
I think it's the first time I've blocked it yet.
Winner take all.
Yeah. That's so gay about Remy. Low parry, go into your fucking raw low forward. That's nothing.
Do, man. Let's play real characters. Human being characters. Roar's cool. I like that fucking cold blue kick, fucking go get out of fucking jail.
Yeah. You learned something today.
Yeah.
Fucking cool name for a move too. Welcome to the world of
Alright. Pherai have a Makoto.
It used to be okay, man. I'll give it a fucking try. I used to rank it in my top 5 characters.
Okay.
I don't know if I would anymore. I played a lot of Makoto on, like, you know, Wednesday nights at Tenchu. And then maybe between, like, 2013 and now.
I'll play Dudley since we did that last week.
Yeah, that's a good idea.
I bet Blance's Mac is way worse than Pherai's.
Thank you.
Rindo Khan. Fucking default boys matches here.
Standing
ladders. Yep.
that he used to fucking carrying the trumpets.
Well, you can watch me play. I think my Dudley's my top five. For sure.
I don't know. It's better to do fucking Tulsa or fucking Seiju.
Seiju. I like Seiju.
You always pick Seiju.
Not for his Q.
Well, that's stupid.
I think my Ken's better than a lot of my other characters.
Jump in round.
Yeah. I do that until people start punishing it, and then I do this fucking anti jump around ass game. It's just like walking the dog. That's what I call it. My Ken's better than my Necro, for sure. I was joking about that Necro thing earlier. Necro over Yurian Yang? Yeah.
I don't think so. Ryan's just cocky.
Yeah. My Ibuki really sucks. I'll be honest on that one. Moro's not too good.
I don't want to get it. Sorry. I think Ibuki's whack. But if you like Ibuki, that's cool. If you like Third Strike, Ibuki, that's cool. You have the sickest Street Fighter 4, I don't know. Fuck it.
Yeah.
usually does the trick.
He goes pretty fucking fast. Oh, I fucking just slid right into that one.
Got out to do dart shot.
Hit the fucking fingernails, dude.
Yeah.
He goes hard, man. He's too fucking... I don't know. My Q's better, I think, because he has the car throw. He goes fucking... I don't know. It doesn't flow.
Oh, no!
Oh, come on! So that was pretty fun.
Yeah, I like playing both sides of that matchup. I don't know why people, it's always like Dudley and Ryu or Dudley and Yuri. Dude, Dudley and Makoto, that's sick.
I think they did that at fucking Mutant before.
Oh, really?
I think so.
You should do it again.
Yeah, that was not a good match, Lance. I watched it recently again.
What's that?
When you lost to Cookie, Elena.
And yeah, it's a bummer. Just laugh about it. What are you gonna do?
Laugh it off.
And I've got a lot of practice laughing. Quick.
Alright. I'm feeling a little fucking. Oh.
Quick.
Cool.
12. Thanks. Yeah, this is what we're doing.
I don't know. What should we do? I feel like I'm just getting in the third strike mode.
Decide. I'm gonna take a piss.
Oh. What do you guys think? Any suggestions? What do you guys think?
All right, that's cool. Fighters ready. Engage.
Yeah. See, we got fucking. Today might be a new record. EX Tatsu and Shippu.
I gotta try that.
Fucking gonna kill him now. Oh, I thought I would go on the other side. Oops.
You win. Alright, that's cool.
Goki versus Yang? My Yang? Yeah, because I don't know. My Goki's pretty fucking garbage. Yeah, I think people want to see Pherai Goki. Because Pherai other characters aren't exactly where they should be.
Oh, fucking hot out.
Yeah, it's hot.
It's swamp.
How do you feel about Yang Goki?
I assume you don't mean...
No, yeah.
Like, playing it, or, like, my opinion on it?
Yeah, both.
Sometimes I like playing against Yang. I really don't like playing against Rom. You know? Rom is gay. I can't take enough opportunity to say that. I kind of enjoy playing it.
All right, let's try it out. Lance said, fuck Rom.
Okay, thank you.
Rom's really cool. I like Rom.
Yeah, one of the reasons I'm sad about not going to have him is it's usually the only time I ever see him anymore.
Tension, so cute, tight.
It's a good guy.
She's the land. Hey man, come on.
I'm gonna use it again.
I know, but it's gross. That's right with my computer.
It even shows wrong color for you. That's right. God, that combo is impossible on OE. Sometimes it goes well, and sometimes it goes really bad against Ye. It's not a good match.
I'm having a little bit of trouble with my EXs. I don't know what that's about. But I feel like they're not coming, when I want them to. It's OE, man. 1-1. Jair Rodriguez for you.
Sometimes it's good.
That was too far. I challenge that.
The game's wrong.
On the match for Sneeka, I mean,
let's do that after the sets.
That's a loaded question.
Yeah, wait. you gotta tune in for, you know, the last half hour of the show.
Gookie gets done too fast.
What's the question?
Why is it good for a game?
Why is what good for a smash? Oh, come on! Should be obvious. Fucking... You can punish everything so well. You can go underneath fireballs, man. Gang is better against...
Yeah. Come on, Pherai.
It's not a good character playing a fucking match. It's good practice.
Need to just buy new buttons, dude. All new buttons. I'm fucking... Whole new setup. Say fucking suck it. Yeah, go to exit. Alright, probably have time for maybe one more grand finale. What do you think? The grand finale. I know Lance wants some Chun-Li. I don't know what everyone else thinks.
I'll play my Ken against you, Chun-Li. I mean, I don't expect it to be any good.
Okay, let's do it.
America.
Alright. First of five.
Gotta remember who I'm fucking playing here.
Cards are here. We get this out.
So gay, but suddenly you mess up and then do low jab. Nothing can go wrong.
Yeah, I don't know. Fucking buttons are acting up today. It's like 18 card throws that match. That was not good. Let's... Hopefully that was just an adjustment. I can do the car throw. It is a little different though, I do agree. I don't know, it feels weird. Yeah.
Pherai. Everyone's rooting for you, dude. That's fucking nice of them. Everyone likes an underdog, you know?
I like how Pherai misses punishes just to give us a good show. Yeah, I made that fucking Derek Neal avatar. Just everyone got it. It was sick.
Yeah, it was really tight.
Yourself pain.
I was surprised.
Did you fucking...
Because of the fucking default jump roundhouse. It was the first move I did in Street Fighter history.
Jimmy Lee. Blew it.
Classics never die. Jump roundhouse. Don't forget, kids. Fucking hate that move. stinger.
Someone parries, but there's just enough time for your EX to get spent and not come out.
Yeah, like that.
That's
that
fucking
one.
Great.
Basically, just come in your face right there.
Yeah. Awesome. I can't do a super anymore. And I got hit.
You'd have done anything else if I got hit by it. Finish up at 3:20, so we have 30 minutes.
Oh, shit.
We can play a little more.
Oh, okay.
I thought it was gonna go a little longer, not to diss you.
Shut the fuck up.
No, I just... Yeah. The fucking bee sting is too good, man.
God, it's too good. Suggestions.
Yeah, Chun is a good character.
Yeah, too good.
Why don't we switch that?
What, me play Chun?
Yeah, your Chun was pretty good last time.
I fucking played against your Oro, dude.
Okay. Yeah. I want to rematch my Urien versus your Goku. I lost it that first time we played.
That's pretty good.
It was pretty good. It was pretty good. Let's go to Mexico. Alright, I lost this last time. Let's see if I can do better this time. Oh no. Uh-oh.
just socked me. This is really, this is pretty hard, but did my best here. Oh man.
I'm on to it. Second tackle ready, but
fucking shit.
Ages for Butterfingers, dude. Just didn't come out. Anyways.
I shouldn't have fucking started the round with an instant air suit.
Yeah, that was really stupid. Why'd you do that?
I was fucking up, you know? I fucking was trying to do low forward super at the beginning of the round. It's really get, good against Urien.
And you get fucking,
time, this fucking OE shit, man. That's a fucking great start to a round for anybody. Oh. Free huge punish.
Yeah, do fucking
damn it.
Into the heat of battle. Go for it.
Okay, okay, I gotta fucking stop doing that.
Yeah.
didn't even do that, bro.
Oh man, if I carried that, we got the fucking.
I know.
I've been bad. Damage, boy. Can't fucking jump, dude. Good match. 2-1.
Yeah, wow.
I'm figuring shit out. Like, not making adjustments.
This is important.
Yeah, it's more than a match.
Yeah, it is. If I lose this, my whole day is gonna be ruined.
That's what I'm going for.
Drink too much as it is. Oh, come on, man.
I don't know what that was. That was sick though. Standing short into fucking Wade headbutt. I'll take it.
That was funny. Oh my god, dude, that was Wake Up Demon!
My fucking EX doesn't come.
That's fucking wake up demon.
3-2, 4-2. I think it was 3-2. 4-2.
Yeah.
About to ruin days here.
Gutex video and thought, that match is impossible. It's 9-1. It's not really that bad.
You just can't, Urien can't jump. That's the hardest part about that match.
Yeah.
So I have to just walk around.
Yeah.
Well, that was fun. Need to get buttons.
Yeah.
Alright, so who's fucking still watching this? Let's do a little roll call here. Yeah, let me try, figure that out later.
Yeah.
Let's see.
While you're doing whatever you're doing, I don't think we really realized when we were doing this that we are broadcasting at the same time as the Boiler Room. So sorry to those guys. I hope we are not taking viewers away from them. You know, everybody has fucking smartphones and computers except for me. I don't have either. But... You know, watch both at the same time. I want to, I did a little fucking, you know, thank you to contributors to the scene last week, so it's a good time to say, like, big ups to the fucking Larios brothers, man, Ricky and Rudy. Yeah, Boiler Room's been going on for, what, like 2 or 3 years now. That place is sick, man. It was a real fucking shame when, not just family close, but then Japan Arcade close. And for there to not be, like, any place for people in North L.A. to play sucks balls. Because North L.A. was where FFA was. North L.A. was where fucking Dengen was. And so it was an area with a lot of strong players. for that to just have a void of places to play was horrible. So when they stepped up and started doing the boiler room sessions, I was really sick. And they've done some really good broadcasts over the past couple of years. I remember watching, this was last year, I think. I was in New Zealand at the time, but it was when Mika came out to the boiler room.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
And that was sick, man.
That was cool.
That was really cool, seeing him play against Yi and Pyro. Something I wanted to see for a really long time. So, I really am thankful to those guys. It's such a hospitable place, you know. They really make you feel comfortable even your first time there. They're really cool guys. So you're doing fucking, you know, the work of the Third Strike gods, Ricky and Rudy. Thank you. You are the stars of the week.
Yeah, man. They're really cool guys. Really nice.
Super nice.
This guy says he met you at Dawn's. Hope you remember me.
Yeah, man. Definitely, dude. Next week, I'll give a shout out to Dawn's. I only one at a time when we run out of all of them. But yeah, the crew at Dawn's is really cool. One thing I like about Third Strike in 2016 is most of the like old fucking asshole behavior is gone, you know?
Yeah, pretty much, for the most part.
Yeah, when I was coming up playing in Family in like 2007 and shit, no one was gonna be your social standing was really tied to your ability as a player. You know, if you weren't good, you were a faggot. Which I think some people still see that as a virtue. I don't really, because I think first, you know, who knows what people could still be playing today who got shied away from the game in like 2006 and 2007 because people were dicks.
Well, the thing is like back in 2006, like the good people were fucking not cool. Like a lot of them.
Yeah.
So that was like, it's changed now. Most of the good people, like Nika, very nice guy.
Yeah, definitely.
So kind of changed.
Yeah, I think a lot of the people that put out content that do well in tournaments are a lot more approachable than people were back in the day. I was still very fortunate to live within driving distance of FFA. I don't want to paint with a broad brush. I feel like when I was first entering FFA tournaments, and it wasn't like fucking, you know, Pyro took me aside and gave me a bunch of tips. But, you know, like Matt Chin was running tournaments back then. And so he was helpful to somebody that didn't know anybody trying to enter a tournament. Back in those days, fucking Gutex was running tournaments.
Yeah.
And I don't know. I mean, enough people blow smoke up his ass. I don't need to be like, thank you, Gutex, you know? But he was real cool back then, man. I mean, still been a cool guy to me over the years, but just, he reached out to the new guys, Matt did. People did reach out to the new guys then, but it was a little bit more clicky. And I guess maybe people see clickiness to this day, but I don't think it's as bad as it was back in the day.
Yeah, I can agree.
I've heard Lance say that before, like, one of the, you know, he's sad that he didn't come play during the glory days, but at the same time, he's very thankful that he's been able to speak directly to really good players in his early years of playing Third Strike. So I think that's nice, you know, the smaller scene has made people realize, like, highly skilled players realize that it's important to reach out to the new guys.
Yeah, it's a good thing. I mean, I don't know if anyone's really going to pick this game up anymore. I mean, in Japan, people still start playing, but...
Yeah.
As long as the scene stays like this, it's pretty good.
Yeah, I mean, I see guys at Safari that, like, quite clearly haven't been playing the game for more than a year or two.
Yeah.
So that's hopeful. I don't mean that as a diss. You know? but it's, I... Like that, I'm happy to see that. I'm not like, oh, this guy sucks, you know. Like, I'm happy to see people that like are learning, you know.
Yeah.
there's no reason for that to not continue. I think people were still doing that, you know, 15 years after ST came out. There are people trying to learn the game, you know, from Jump Street. So there's no reason it couldn't happen with Third Strike, but I, you know, it'd be crazy if I anticipated 1,000 people playing Third Strike.
Yeah, no, that's not going to happen.
Yeah.
Any questions? Any other questions?
Did we have any questions in the SRK thread?
No, we had some questions, but I deleted. I closed the chat on accident. So.
Oh really?
Well,
someone wanna. I think we covered this on the first broadcast a little bit, but is there anything you want to say about playing Nika? Like, or how about even more generally? If you don't want to say anything specifically about Nika, what do you think is like the steps to follow if you're preparing for like a gotchi or one of those fight card things that they do?
Well, yeah. Well, I've only done that once in my life when I played Kairu, and that day I was so hungover.
So you probably didn't do.
I didn't do anything. I pretty much showed up to Newton like, because I worked on Mondays. You know, it's just a Monday. I can't really go. And so I just asked for this one Monday off so I can do the gotchi. So because I had Monday off, I fucking let loose on Sunday. You know, just like, fuck, I got Monday off. I'm not doing anything tomorrow. So I just got super fucking wasted. And then Monday I felt awful. And I still won. I was like nauseous the whole time. So yeah, I don't really do much to prepare.
Well, I mean, you're gonna do something differently, I imagine, this time, are you?
Well, I mean, I'm not gonna like. Nah, I mean, you can't really do that too much because, like, if I'm gonna play Kairu or something, or like, for example, I'm gonna play fucking Nika. Like, I can't just go watch every one of his matches and be like, oh, I got it figured out now, because good players adapt. So it's not like I'm gonna see something clearly that's gonna help me. But I mean, a little bit. It's just not that big of a deal. It's more just Chun-Li versus Yang. And I have a lot of Yang experience, so that's basically how I feel about it. What would you do?
I would watch a lot of videos. A lot of their videos. And, well, the beauty of my situation is if it was someone evenly matched with me, they're not a good player. So they're not going to make adjustments.
Okay.
Yeah, so I need to know their tendencies. It's really important for me. But yeah, of course, like matchup stuff. Heaven forbid I'd be playing like against a Yang or an Oro. That would be shitty.
Yeah.
But yeah, I've never played a money match. I've never played a gotchi besides this casual shit that we do, you know. Or unless... Yeah, I mean, nothing like official, like something that's like headlined in a tournament or like a live stream from Newton. You know, I don't really count this or just like casually saying it at a game center, like, yo, Daisuke, you want to run a 1-3, you know?
Yeah.
I've never really done it before, but I'd probably over prepare. But I wouldn't ask me.
Yeah, well, I mean, what I do for Cooperation Cup is I just play against every character, like trying to play perfect, because I can't like be like, oh, maybe I'm gonna face fucking Ricky Maru in the semifinals. I should study his videos, because then, you know what I mean, you might not even end up making it that far or even playing him. So
but yeah, tournaments a lot different. That's hard. I think then matchup knowledge is more important.
Yeah, but I don't know. I don't feel like, I mean, I don't know. I don't get it. I mean, how do I say it? I already played against, like, regular KO, so I don't... If I play against him and do alright, I feel, like, pretty confident, so...
Confidence is good.
Yeah.
I always think, yeah, that's the biggest difference maker, not just Third Strike, but everything. Not arrogance, but confidence is huge. If you could magically take a confidence pill, that give you such a boost and an ability in Third Strike more than anything else. I wish I had.
Yeah.
Somebody make confidence pills. Where's the medical community at? Right,
well, now? Three beers does it.
That's true. But you lose something.
Yeah, you lose something.
Yeah. I'm always confident when I smoke weed, too, but I'm also a little overconfident. or I just do stuff because I think it'd be fun. I really want to land this comp. I'll keep trying.
So Lance said, predict whether Lance will make top 8 at TFC.
But they want a prediction.
Lance wants you to predict for himself.
Me?
No, for Lance. Lance is saying, do you predict I'll get top 8?
I think that's a really good chance. Lance's biggest enemy at TFC will be himself.
Yeah, I agree.
I think Lance's fundamental skills are really good. He hits, like, when I play him, Goki versus Trent, he really abuses matchup stuff, which is good. You know, really abuses matchup stuff. So I think that's a big feather in his cap. There's a select few players that I think have a big edge over him skill-wise. That's a really small handful of players. I think the majority of active players he should be able to beat. So I'm not a betting man. I think Lance is entirely capable of making top 8.
That's a good safe answer.
Yeah, you're totally capable of making top 8, and I don't mean like you'll eke your way into 7th place. I think you could make 5th or 4th place. You have the skills for it. The biggest issue is going to be your confidence that day.
Need that confidence boner, dude.
Yeah, I think that's probably Lance's biggest weakness is not enough experience playing in tournament. Although, you know, you can circumvent that. I've been playing in tournaments for years, and I still get nervous. You know, I think I did better than I expected to at Coupe because I was really fucking drunk.
Yeah, dude. John was so drunk, and it was like 9:40 in the morning. And he was like, he couldn't even stand up straight.
Yeah, exactly. I've always had a problem with tournament nerves. So I understand it, man. That really makes you suffer as a player. So, I don't know, man. Take up yoga or meditation or something. If you're feeling good that day, I think you have a shot at 5th or 4th place.
Yeah.
But there are some heavy hitters there. I don't expect to see Lance in grand finals.
Sorry, Lance.
Because, I mean, look, it's going to be you, there's going to be Nika, there's Yuki, there's Yi, there's
Mr.
Exo.
Mr. Bean,
yeah, Sherwin. Who else? I know I'm forgetting people. I'm not really familiar with the
East Coast guys.
Yeah, I don't know them that well. Mutant will be there. I don't really know the skill level of the guys other than that. You know, I see them play against each other, but
yeah,
it doesn't reveal a lot to me. I need like a guys like Ahmed and Frankie. Be easier for me to judge their skill if it was them playing against people I've played against before. So I'm not saying I'm just not including them in my predictions, you know, because I don't know their skill.
But they're probably hungry too.
Well, fuck yeah, that's a big part of it. Is you know the I know James, Mr. Bean is good, really good. I know Sherwin is good, but they're not playing frequently, or they weren't before I came to Japan, you know? But these guys on the East Coast are, and they're playing a lot from what I gather, and that makes a big difference. So it's going to be exciting.
Yeah, I mean, I wouldn't focus too much on getting top 8. Just try not to lose against any fucking people you shouldn't lose to. Like, you know what I mean? Like, if you go and you fucking lose to Yi and, you know, Nika, you just got bad luck in the brackets or something.
Yeah, I can live with that.
Yeah. Just don't lose to the fucking Elena player, dude. Cookie.
But I think one of the big common mistakes is you looking past the match you're playing, you know? Like, looking at the bracket and being like, oh, I've never heard of this guy. So
the next guy I have to play is so-and-so, and I feel good against him.
Yeah.
And then I'll be in top eight.
Yeah.
You know, so take tournaments one match at a time. Don't start looking to the horizon, you know, where your top eight finishes. You know, take it one match at a time. Because if you start, every opponent, even if they suck, dude, you know, try to beat them down as bad as possible.
Yeah, I remember
one
story at what was that? Where was the one at UCI?
That was SoCal Regionals.
SoCal Regionals, like you lost to like that one really nice guy that plays Rocket Dudley. Remember?
Yeah.
Total upset.
He's really cool guy.
Cool guy, but it was like a big upset for you. Maybe because you were looking past it, like, oh, I don't, yeah, you know what I mean? You just.
Well, I'm saying this from personal experience. I've done that so many times. But yeah, that guy, he got like Stan Roundhouse, Jeppa Rocket punish every time.
Like four times, dude.
Yeah, every time he got it perfect. You know? That hurts bad against him. But he's not a bad player.
No, it was just...
I never heard of him, and I thought, well, I don't know who the fuck this guy is. I play against, you know, Victoli.
Sherwin. I play against fucking...
Yeah. So
other Dudleys.
What do I got to worry about? And, I got smashed.
Yeah, fucking...
I've done that a lot of times in tournament. It's looking past the match that you're playing, and I think that's really stupid. Just, 2 minutes being in your own head, kind of reminding yourself of like what you do against that character, or if you know the player, what you do against that player, makes a big difference.
Yeah, me too. I at Evo long time ago, I lost to just a pad player. My first Evo.
It sucks.
I was just, you know, oh, if I win this one, I'll have to play Mike Watson next, and then I could be in top eight maybe.
Yeah.
And I just lost, and that's that. Well, good luck, Lance. Good luck to everyone going.
I hope everyone's practicing.
Yeah, Lance, are you playing? I don't think you're playing.
Yeah. As God knows, when there's going to be another tournament where, tournament that resembles TFC at all in the United States. I mean, I think it's really cool that there's some of my boys from SoCal that are going. I think it's really cool that Lance is going. I think it's really cool that those guys from New York have been playing a lot over the past few years. You know, I know it's in North Carolina, but I'm sure anybody on the East Coast kind of looks at it like, you know, East Coast is our territory. So I know that that's going to be a big motivator for those guys. You know, I doubt that they want to see you come and win or Yi come and win, or Yuki come and win. So those guys, I'm sure, are, you know, playing pretty ruthlessly.
What do you think? What's your top five results prediction?
Top five results.
Start with the bottom. 5-4-3-2-1.
Well, I'd be tied for fifth.
Yeah.
Tied for fifth. Throw him a bone right here. Here's my fifth placers. I'm going to say it's Lance.
Ooh.
And Mr. Bean.
Mr. Bean.
Yeah, Lance and Mr. Bean.
Fourth?
Fourth place.
Who did they lose to? Who did Lance and Mr. Bean lose to?
Well, let me do the top four first, and then we'll figure that out.
All right.
I see... a good question, man.
No, not thinking too much. Just gotta spit it out.
You gotta spit it out, eh?
Yeah.
I see it being... I see maybe Ryan and Yi for third and fourth place. And you lost to Yuki, who gets in top two with... Yuck Dog and Lloyd.
Lloyd.
Yeah. I
feel like Lloyd will pull out something pretty fucking nasty in the singles tournament. What do you think?
Oh, who did Lance and fucking Bean lose to?
What was my prediction again?
It's you and me and third and fourth, and then Yuki and Roy top two.
Bean lost to you. Lance lost to you.
Lance. I'm gonna go. Fifth.
That's tough though, dude, because I know you were saying that you've done pretty good against Yuck Dog in the past, so that's a coin flip.
Yeah.
And fucking Anika and Yee's a coin flip too, it's tough. Top four is hard. That's arbitrary.
Yeah, the top four is pretty much dependent on brackets. Someone's gonna get a fucking free ride to semifinals.
I see the Titans in top four unless something weird happens in the brackets. But how that breaks down is anybody's guess.
Yeah.
I think it really depends on what's happening that day. What's interesting will be the bottom four. I see that being Bean and Lance, and then after that. I'll leave the spot open for one of those New York guys that I'm leaving out of the equation because I don't know them. And then.
Yeah, I'm going to. For fifth, tied for fifth, I'll put. Probably. One of the New York guys. Maybe. And then. I want to say, like. Bean. Fourth, I'm gonna put Nika. Third, I'm gonna put Yi and Yuki, and then me first. Cause I think Yi will do, like, he won, or he did really well against Nika last time right at the Boiler Room.
It was close, but he won. Yeah, close, but he won.
And I think Yi just really hates losing, so I think he'll pull that out.
Yeah, he does hate losing.
I mean, everyone hates losing, but he'll really be fucking mad. Yuki's not gonna lose because of the opponent. He's gonna lose just because he'll get frustrated or something, I think. Otherwise, he could win. He could be first too.
You're confident in yourself.
Yeah. I mean, I'm confident now, like going to fucking. What's today? Tuesday? I'll go to Mikado and win that tournament tonight.
Yeah, I can see that. Looking forward to it.
Oh, yeah, EXO, too. Yeah, EXO's in there, too.
Oh, my God, I completely forgot about him.
Oops.
Yeah, then... I don't know, EXO would be one of the contenders for one of the fifth place spots. He could be in top four, too. I know... I think he does pretty good against Nika, right?
Yeah, maybe. EXO for third place.
I don't know how EXO does against Yi. Did they play when Yi went out to New York? I don't know. I'll do a little bit of research when I'm, you know, trying to fall asleep some night, watch some old videos. I'll give a more accurate prediction next show.
Yeah. Yeah, I think the biggest problem too is not only Yuki's gonna lose because he's gonna get frustrated. I also think he's got it harder than anyone else because he has zero people to play with until then.
That's true, man. That's gonna be really rough for him.
And that's a big fucking weight. On him.
His training is the most handicapped.
Yeah. Whereas Nika is gonna be playing every day with his fucking boys.
That's true.
I can play every day if I want to.
And he's still got a pretty good situation.
Yeah.
He doesn't have a lot of people to play against. I guess that's not much different than Nika.
If EXO can land Dart Shot Super, he has a real chance. So you gotta work on that.
That's every Dudley player's best friend.
All right. Well, we gotta get going.
So, reminder. Please send us your questions. Yeah. Or send us your requests.
Thank you to all the viewers.
Yeah, yeah. And I hope you guys were watching the Boiler Room too. And we'll be back when?
In 2 days.
In 2 days. Yeah, so check us out Wednesday around 9 o'clock Pacific Standard Time.
Yeah, post in the Facebook or Shuriken any kind of request or anything.
We watch Third Strike Junkies, so just reply to one of Ryan's threads or on SRK. I don't have any social media, but what's your Twitter?
I don't even use it much, but you don't remember. Yeah, I don't remember. Yeah. But yeah, just
the Third Strike Junkies.
Just favorite this channel, and you'll get an email when we go live.
Yeah, in two days. And keep watching Third Strike, or you posting on Third Strike Junkies and send your questions there. So, from fucking Saitama, Japan, this is Ryan and Pherai signing off.
Cheers. Let's drink beers.
That's right.
Later.